Good morning, children. Welcome back to online classes of Sri Gokulam Guruvayur. In the previous class, we have studied about the measurement of national income in value-added method. I hope you studied the basic terms and formulas in value-added method. So today, we are going to solve some numericals on value-added method. So let's start our session. Today, we are going to solve some numericals on value-added method. Let us move to the first question. Given the following data, find out net value added at factor cost by a firm. We have total sales, purchase of raw materials, net indirect taxes and consumption of fixed capital. We have to find out net value added at factor cost. What is the formula for finding net value added at factor cost? That is NVAFC is equal to GVAMP minus depreciation minus NIT, that is net indirect taxes. So what is GVAMP? GVAMP is the gross value added at market price. So gross value added at market price is otherwise known as GDPMP in value added method. So GVAMP is equal to value of output minus intermediate consumption. So what is value of output? Value of output or VO is equal to sales plus change in stock plus production for self-consumption plus export. Here in our question, there is no information regarding production for self-consumption and export and also change in stock. So it's regarded as zero. So here value of output is equal to sales. Then we can write NVAFC, that is net value added at factor cost, is equal to sales minus IC minus depreciation minus NIT. That is the expanded form of first equation. GVMP, that is sales minus IC, then minus depreciation, then minus net indirect taxes. Then here NVAFC is equal to sales, that is 75,000 minus IC. IC in this question, the purchase of raw materials. That is the IC, intermediate consumption, rupees 30,000 minus depreciation. Depreciation is otherwise known as consumption of fixed capital. That is 2,500 minus NIT. Here we have given direct NIT, net indirect tax, that is 7,500. So we will get rupees 35,000 crore as the NVAFC. Okay, students. So next, second question. Firm A sells goods to firm B for rupees 100 crore. Firm B sells goods to firm C for rupees 160 crore. Firm C sells goods to consumer for rupees 200 crore. Find out value of gross value of output and gross value added. Also calculate net value added at factor cost if replacement cost is rupees 50 crore, subsidies are rupees 10 crore, indirect taxes are rupees 30 crore. So here we have to find out three aggregates, that are gross value output, gross value added and also calculate net value added at factor cost. So first one, value of output or VO. Gross value of output is the total sale of producer. Here we have three producer, firm A, firm B and firm C. The total sale of these firms is known as value of output. That is, firm sells goods to firm B rupees 100, firm B sells goods to firm C rupees 160 crore, then firm C sells goods to consumer for rupees 200 crores. So total value of output is 100 plus 160 plus 200, that is 460 crore. So if we get value of output, we can calculate gross value added. What is gross value added? Value of output minus intermediate consumption. So we have already calculated VO, value of output. Then what is intermediate consumption here? The intermediate consumption is the expenditure of producers or purchase of goods and services. Here we have three producers. Then firm A doesn't purchase anything from anyone. Then B purchase goods from firm A at rupees 100. And firm C purchase goods from firm B at rupees 160 crore. Then firm C sells goods to consumer. The consumer expenditure is not regarded as intermediate consumption. So it's not included. Rupees 200 crore is not included in the intermediate consumption. Only 100 and 160 is the intermediate consumption, the value of intermediate consumption. So gross value added is equal to VO minus IC, that is 460 minus 260. 260 can be obtained by 100 plus 160, that is purchase of firm B and firm C. So it is 200. Gross value added is equal to 200. Then the next value we have to calculate is net value added at factor cost. Net value added at factor cost is equal to GVAMP minus depreciation minus NIP, because we have gross value added at market price. So if you want to convert gross value into net value, minus or deduct depreciation from gross value, then we have to convert MP, that is market price, into factor cost. So we have to deduct NIT, net indirect tax, from gross value MP. Okay, so NVAFC is equal to GVAMP minus depreciation minus NIT. So NVAFC is equal to, what is GVAMP here? It is 200 minus 50. 50 is the depreciation or replacement cost. Depreciation is otherwise known as replacement cost, that is rupees 50 crore. So 200 minus 50 minus NIT, net indirect tax. What is the net indirect tax? Indirect tax minus subsidies, that is 30 minus 10, that rupees 20. So we will get NVFC is equal to rupees 130 crore. Next, the third question is, calculate sales from the following data. So we have subsidies, opening stock, closing stock, intermediate consumption, consumption of fixed capital, profit, net value added at factor cost. So here there is only one national income aggregate, that is net value added at factor cost. So we have to find out sales from net value added at factor cost. So what is net value added at factor cost, or NVAFC? It can be calculated by GVAMP minus depreciation minus NIT, that we have already discussed. So we have to write it in an expanded form. So what is GVAMP? GVAMP is equal to value of output minus intermediate consumption. Then what is VO? Value of output is equal to sales plus change in stock. So we can written as NVFC is equal to sales plus change in stock minus IC minus depreciation minus NIT. So it is an expanded form of the first equation. Sales plus change in stock, that is VO minus IC, GVAMP minus depreciation minus NIT, net indirect tax. So put the value of all these items. That is, NBFC is equal to 2000 lakhs is equal to sales. We don't know about sales. So, it's written as sales. Plus, change in stock. What is change in stock? Closing stock minus opening stock. That is, 600 minus 100 lakhs. 600 minus 100 lakhs minus intermediate consumption. Here the intermediate consumption is 3000 lakhs minus depreciation. In the question, depreciation is termed as consumption of fixed capital. It is another name of depreciation. Consumption of fixed capital, that is rupees 700 lakhs minus NIT, net indirect tax, that is minus 200. So how can we calculate net indirect tax? Net indirect tax is equal to indirect taxes minus subsidies. Here there is no any information regarding indirect tax, so it is regarded as zero. Indirect tax is regarded as zero. So NIT is equal to zero minus 200, that is negative 200. Okay, then 200, NVFC is 200 plus sales plus 600 minus 100, 500 minus 3000 minus 700, that is both are in negative form, so it will add and put the negative sign. 3000 minus 700, that is 3000 plus 700, and put the negative sign, that is minus 3700. Then here these both are in negative form, so it will be positive. Okay, if there is two negative form, it will be positive, so it is plus 200. That is 2000 is equal to sales minus 3000. Then, if we bring this negative 3000 into this side, what happened? It will be positive. So, 2000 plus 3000 is equal to sales. That is rupees 5000 lakhs. So, sale in this question is 5000 lakhs. Okay, students, I hope you understood this. So, we have discussed about few numericals related to value added method. You can expect questions from the numerical part. So, you have to practice it well. For this, I will give you more questions like this. Try it and try to solve these questions. So, children, see you in the next class with new topic. Until then, bye.